Hello, and welcome back to Quinnville, and this lovely view from the Hawthorne Brook Nature Reserve. I'm Mars, and today we'll be working on a few more changes from City Planner Play's City Tips video. First, we're going to redevelop some of the land we freed up last time by moving the city services to the new service and industrial district on the west side. Then, we're going to do a bit more work in the new district, plus make some adjustments to the transit network. For today's neighborhood focus, and for the first part of our build, let's visit the area across the tracks from the Gulfside Industrial Park, just north of the Crown Point Animal Sanctuary. This was originally a small city services core located on the outskirts of town, with a rural suburb to the north, an industrial area to the east, and undeveloped land to the south. That changed when George and Carla Fion, there's that name from last week's overpass, saw an opportunity and purchased the rocky Crown Point Peninsula for relatively cheap. The land was right next to the cargo harbor, near an industrial district and a city services district, so it could be had for a bargain, but that didn't stop the retired couple, he a former corporate investment fund manager of no little success, and she a veterinary surgeon known nationwide, from seeing its potential. Once their new animal sanctuary was up and running, however, another enterprising developer built a new upscale neighborhood on Tower Hill to the north. The city built a new park just north of that, and homeowners in what is now West Grove and Delta Vista saw their land values skyrocket. Suddenly, the once logical city services area no longer made sense. Now that it's been cleared out, the city has sold off the land to a new developer at a tidy profit, and it's time for us to get building. So first off, let's take a look at what we're working with here. Got some parking in here that definitely does not need to be, so I can move one down to this area. Big gap in the zoning, so I'm going to tie Hickory Street in. So do that right now. Move right down to there. Junk out of here. In fact, I'm gonna clear out a lot of those trees. We're gonna do this a bit nicer. Okay, so let's get some paths in here. We're gonna make this a really nice area. I'm gonna turn off everything but angle. Want to do this one after all. I'm going to leave that empty. We'll just stick some trees in there. Let things start to develop while we build up what's going to be on the inside. So I'm going to make this all commercial because it's right down here by the zoo or the animal sanctuary. I think that makes a lot of sense to leave this as is. And then we'll have our new residential stuff up here. Get into what I want to do with this, as I have some plans here. We're going to make this into a really, really nice area. Without turning it into a park proper, we're still going to give it that sort of feel. I actually saw something like this driving around the other day here in Phoenix, and I thought it was a really, really cool idea. And thought it would work really nicely in my build. So here it comes. Just gonna get some vendors in here. But forgot to put trash in there. Definitely want to have that in place so we don't get any littering. Me as I fiddle for where this trees. I had the perfect tree type to put in here, and I have to find them. Here we go. I these will do for us. They've got a skinny trunk, great big tall canopy, so there's tons of room underneath here still to run around and do whatever, sit and have a picnic. Tons of space, tons of shade. It gives you a nice big full canopy without cluttering ground level, so you still have a bunch of room for activity. Oops, and I should not have let this go because I need to make a district, and I want to set the district to a certain type. So I apologize, people whose homes are about to go away. Bring these buildings here into the new district that we're making. Fittingly, we're going to call this Town Point Gardens. Set that to European suburbia. Give us a clear differentiation from Delta Vista up here. I'm going to fill in detailing in the rest of this area, and then we can move on. I absolutely love these little Maria bushes. They're great to put in all sorts of different places. I'm going to use my line tool here and stick those in all along this path. That's too much. Use our brush with our standard mix of trees to fill in right here. We'll have to do some of that manually to get it in close enough. That's the one problem with the brush, is it's really reluctant to put anything too near to anything else. That was terrible timing. We're gonna build a house just as I was going to delete that extra bit of path that we missed earlier. Feels like down here, even though I don't like how that worked out. You know what, I'm going to change these to the self-leveling paths, and we'll use those to make it look better. There, that feels much, much nicer. Look at that, look at how much room you'd have to do whatever you wanted down there. I'm sure that Bethany there appreciates it. Also going to fill in back here. Now that we've got residential development on there, we don't need the rail making quite so much noise in this neighborhood. And there you have it. All right, so let's move over to our district that we built last time. Do some things down here. First of all, well, you can see that we've got some abandonment issues and lack of employees. That is going to hopefully be helped by the new residential area that we put in. But otherwise, until we get some more extensive residential, there's not a lot that we can do about that. But there is something we can do about that poor guy not having any water. Get that extended out to there. And then shouldn't need any more. We'll save that money. I noticed that the street name didn't extend all the way to the end anymore. So we'll do that, and here we don't want to have twice teeing into electric way, so we're just going to call, let's extend that a tiny bit, go to there, and then call this little piece of it Short Street. Now, impact here at times can get quite heavy with traffic coming out here, either to go to the station or to get into the rest of town, so I'm going to change this into asymmetrical here, just to give it a little bit of save us some queuing distance, to have it separate for vehicles going in different directions. I'm going to take out the light here at Diesel and Watershed. That's really not needed anymore. And we're going to turn that into just a stop sign on either side of Watershed there. Now we're gonna add a light here on Solar, because this has gotten quite heavy. But now that we don't have two lights super close to each other, and that will allow us to get a little bit more vehicle throughput. Want to add some commercial into here. I said I was going to do that last time around, and I never did. So we'll just give a place for some shops here in the industrial area, so that the workers can, you know, go grab a bite to eat or something without having to go into town. All right, and then add that into here too. Matter of fact, I'm actually going to change this out to commercial as well. This gets to be really busy. I don't need trucks coming in and out of here onto electric all the time. So we'll do that and call it good. Check on here. We're just too tight on garbage processing. It's not going to give me any room to grow, and I want to take up that space that I have here with that while I have it. So let's come down here. We're going to extend, I believe this is plastic place. Turn back on our snap twos here. And that'll give us room to throw a couple more recycling centers in there. Trying to avoid incinerators because it's really close to the river and I don't want to pollute that too badly. I may end up having to convert one of these into an incinerator, but for now we'll live with what we've got. That'll have water, that'll be fine. Now the next thing I want to do is get some warehouses in here. I find that it's good to have them nice and close to a station. So let's get in here and do some measuring, because I want to put in two warehouses, one for unique goods that are on their way out to the station, and one for zoned commercial stuff that we can store coming in and from the industrial area here. And I may change that unique factory goods to zoned commercial. As a matter of fact, I think I'm going to, because we got our unique factory stuff warehoused just fine elsewhere. I'd rather have some storage to free up the trains, keep them more even coming in. It just gives us a bit of cushion to work with. So we're going to put a couple of these, but we're going to put them on a street that comes down here, down the middle. So I just need to see what kind of account I'm looking at for distance here. So those appear to be 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 deep. Is that what I'm seeing? Yep, 7 deep. I'm gonna solve this by doing a one-way loop from here. Should give us enough space, and we'll double check that now. I'm just going to leave them at balanced. The game seems to me to struggle at any setting other than balanced as far as these warehouses. It operates well when it's set that way. Whoops, wrong one. But it doesn't do very well on fill or empty, either one, in my experience. I'm going to call this stockpile circle. Before we get anywhere here, I need to make sure that we don't let this screw us up too bad, because this could be awful if not treated properly. No turning into there. Let's do that with, you know what, let's do this way instead. I'm gonna put these out. I've been told that it's better for processing, etc., if you use arrows rather than the drawn bits. So we're only allowing right turns in, there we go, and right turns out, no lefts either way. I tried doing it that way, this becomes an absolute mess. So we need cars to come in this way and then go out that way, figure everything else out. however it takes. Let's get that filled in with a little bit of landscaping and make it look nicer. Use some of the trees from that new, some of the new trees, I suppose. They weren't with a content creator pack. They came out at the same time as the airport's DLC, and these are so much nicer than the vanilla trees. I'm starting to, a little bit, to try to move away from the vanilla trees in this build. I know that's pretty much what I have, so I still use that brush, but I may at some point come in here with Bob and just replace them all, because these really are a lot better, a lot more attractive. But I am going to use the Mariah that I like so much to line this area with. And we're all good. Notice people coming back here to park to get to this station, so I'm going to add some parking for this. Unfortunately, in order to fit it in here, I know I'm going to need to de-zone that. I'll do that right off the bat. So It's such a habit for me. I'm like I said last time around, I'm absolutely a pauser. I'm working on getting better. These are under parks. Down here, that's the one. And then I have to use move it to get it to sit where I want. Do nicely right there. Make sure it hasn't hurt our zoning any. We're good there. Throw in a tree on the corner and make it look a little bit better. I'm also going to get rid of some of these stumps again. I want to fence the rail in here since this stuff is really fairly close. We don't need anybody driving off and getting into trouble. So I'm going to fence along here on both sides, really. I'm going to use the ore industry fence on this side. Very industrial looking. I can take everything off but angle. Fence that will screen the stuff on this side of the rails from view from the neighborhood down there. Just end that there under the bridge. Same deal on this side. Okay. For this side, I'm going to use the park fence. Landscaping in here, especially on this side, to shield the neighborhood from all the noise and the sight of all this industrial stuff back here. Again, for now, I'm just going to use my standard brush. Some of that in back here, too. Also see some terrain I want to feather out. Better. Okay, I'm also going to fence in this section here. Why did I look at it? I don't like how that sits, so we're going to nix that one little section. I'm going to use our ore fence here again. Nothing on but angle. Somehow, that back. Do not want you there. Now imagine being where it is in this industrial park. That wouldn't be kept up super nice, so I'm going to fill it in with that wild grass that we got in the new update. This stuff is very nice. Needs to be a little tighter than that. Let's try a 4. That fills in really well. move some of that back away from the sidewalk, but that fills in so well for us. Just grab pieces that are too far out, push them back a little bit, and then we'll add some proper trees in here. A couple of these live oaks will do us. Big one that time. That one got swallowed up, it's so small. I'm gonna change that out. That's better. Stuff is very tall, isn't it? Looks good though. I like it. I will leave it there. Squeeze a few more in here. Beautiful. Let's get this thing districted because we did not do that before and that needs to change. Take this whole area and we'll include the stuff down there along watershed. I don't think I want to do that. I'm going to go back on that. We're going to use University Heights. If I remember right, I have a heavy traffic ban in place on University Heights, so once I get this set up here, I need to pull that off the road so that our trucks can still get through. See, you can tell I already kind of had that cleared out, so I believe that's a heavy traffic ban in place in that area. Of course, doing that tiny little bit of adjustment just doesn't want to let me, does not want to let me do that, does it? It doesn't want it to be that narrow. Well, I guess what we can do is we'll just bring this down here. After all, this in our new district. This is going to be the Arankawa, hope I'm pronouncing that right, industrial area, named after a tribe native to the Gulf area, which is where Quinnville is at. Before I go anywhere else, let's check city services. I want to make sure everything is good back here. We're not missing anything important. Obviously, education doesn't matter for the industrial area, but I feel like I should have a clinic in here someplace. Put that on solar here. Certainly, we'll need fire protection back here. Same deal. Put that off solar. And police is pretty good. We've got this headquarters in place and it's able to serve that area. I'm not going to worry too much about the it fading in the corner there. I will leave that as is. And then the one that everybody always forgets about, let me see if I can even remember where it is. Postal Service. I can never ever figure out where this is at just because I touch it so infrequently. Right, I found it. For some reason, it's under garbage and industry. No idea why, but there it is. We want a regular post office in here. It looks like I did two clinics, and that is not at all what I had intended. So let's get rid of one of those. Come back in. We'll get our post office set up properly on the corner, how it looks nice. Move our clinic down. And we'll build that fire station off of solar as well. Water all the way out there, so we're good as far as that goes. And now I want to come down here. This intersection, which you can tell is already getting pretty busy, backing up a little ways. Plus, I don't like how that parking looks along here, so I'm going to make some changes. We're going to get our three lane either way, either side road. Actually, since this, I want to keep the median since the median's on the bridge. So let's do that. Let's grab our three lane median, no parking, and upgrade all of this to that. Put that on the ground. Then we can do some fixing with visuals here. Take a look at our directionality here. I don't want that to be a two-way lane, left only. If you're going up there, you have to get in that specific lane. Same thing here. I don't like straight and left sharing a space. This, I think I'm going to turn that asymmetric as well, just because I've seen quite a bit of traffic come through there at times. I'm going to leave this one this way because I like that being right only. It just lets everybody who's not here at the light, who's turning right, just continue through without having to make that stop. Let's get this marked up. I did this one wrong. It's more like it. So I have to fix this one. Looks like it got undone with that. I don't think there's enough necessary right-hand turning going into here to warrant that, so let's get that fixed up too. We definitely don't want left sharing the lane with straight, so let's do it that way, make that better. And same deal here, let's make that a right and a straight. And then get rid of the solid marking there. Perfect. Much, much better. See how things are flowing. Everything looks like it's going pretty well still. Excellent. I'm gonna check and see what signalization I have in here. So that's a light, and that's a light, unfortunately, but it is necessary. When I let that off, there's just too much passenger traffic, regular car traffic through here. To let me get away without having that. Here I can do that, and here kind of needs one, so I think we're good. Good everywhere here now. One thing also that I want to do, since Rotor is kind of serving as the major through street here, I want to get all of this signalized with stop signs as well. I don't think I put a stop sign on there, and I need to do that. Okay. Everything else should already be in place. Whoops. Except for that one. There we go. Beautiful. We got our new industrial area. Now, one thing that I realized I did last time, I turned this waste transfer station off. That was not the one that I had meant to set to empty. I had meant to set this one down here, it's empty. But in the meantime, I've decided I'm just going to leave that on because it doesn't really create pollution. If you look at the map, it's not hurting anything by being there. Especially considering what's around it, I'm not super concerned. I'm going to leave that alone. But we definitely want this one turned back on. And we've got one here. This one up here by all these recycling places, it's hardly being used. I'm gonna leave this, put this one on empty. It's already dead, or empty rather. So let's just get rid of it. Save that space for something else. We'll fill that in with trees and call it good for now. Another thing that I missed last time on our new interchange down here. Do this real quick. Just fix the grades. Not ideal, but I'm not going to get too deep into the weeds on this one. I just want it to look not awful, and it does, and it functions fine. I think we can also change these nodes here. It's interesting because it looks like it's not. It definitely does. There we go. It's odd. It looks like it's not sloped, but it says that it is. Oh well, I'm not gonna mess around with that too much. Let's take a look and see what our traffic's doing, because we've done quite a bit to that. 76. It just doesn't go much from there, no matter how nicely things are flowing. This is a heavy traffic area, but it moves. This is all, you know, that orangey color, dark orange, saying, yeah, it's heavy, but it's not a problem. And you're going to find that all over the place in Quinnville. It really is the case that as long as things flow, I can't let myself get worried too much about it. Certainly, traffic is better here than it is in Phoenix at rush hour, so I'm not going to worry. Just little hot spots in places, and nothing's getting stuck, nothing's getting bad, nothing's backing up too much. You know, there's some weird stuff happening sometimes. It's fine, and and I'll treat it like it's fine. But that does bring us to the other thing I want to do today, which is transit rework. There's quite a lot of that that needs doing. Things that I want to look at and touch up. Just take a quick look at our transit, where our numbers are. And I'm going to note this down. We are looking currently at 7,781 residents per week, and 4,696 tourists per week. Most of that on the metro, a fair bit of that on the bus, and then a handful on other modes. So let's get going on seeing if we can't get that improved. First one I want to look at, well, we need a route into this new area for sure. I don't want this to be entirely reliant on. Ooh, I see that body. I'm going to take a real quick look at our death care. And some stuff around here, but judging by the bodies there, it's clearly not enough to handle what's needed. So let's throw a crematorium in here. On this as well, and I also see that I need to extend the name Solar Street out to the end. Much better. So we need a bus route in this area, so I'm gonna start that here by the ferry. And we'll run that into our new area. Stop that by the metro here on the way in. Give a transfer opportunity to everyone in the industrial area, since we don't have any ways for anybody to get across through here. I want to make that transfer available. Now, come up here to, that's not quite the middle of that area. That's good enough. Can walk a little ways to get to that stop. I'm gonna move it to there, and then we want another one by this pocket of industrial over here. And we'll bring that back around on this side. No, I shouldn't do that here we go. And we'll mirror the rest of the way. Perfect. Let's get in here and change the... Can't be the one we're on. Here we go. That's the one. Just University Shores and Karankawa. Perfect. I love using these biofuel buses. Double the capacity of the ones that come with the game. Still have the benefits of actually using them, though I do have some non-biofuel buses in here, as you'll see as I go through this. I love the City Line assets. They keep everything looking nice and uniform. I like how they work. Now, before I move on, let's get our budget for this adjusted. I don't think we're going to need 7 vehicles. I think we'll be just fine with 5 of those, so take it to there. As yeah, you can see it's they're getting some ridership, but it's not a massive amount. So we'll use that. Next one I need to look at is near Cathedral Square here. They have a route that goes right by our station here. Not the one that I wanted. Let's see if I can find it. It's line number 12 is the one that I'm looking for. Here we go. It's this pink one. It goes right by the station in Cathedral Square here. Doesn't stop. That's a tragic missed opportunity, especially since it's feeding this Woodland Hill neighborhood into the transit system in general. I don't like that it's missing such an obvious opportunity. So let's fix that. We're going to bring that in here. And then find the way, the one going back. Same thing there. Now I can already tell you we're going to need to increase the number of vehicles on here. This 15 passenger shuttle will be fine. It's not serving a huge area. It's not going to see a lot of traffic, but we will need to bring it up to, I'm going to say 6 vehicles to make sure that we're not missing anybody on stops here. That will become important, especially since we're stopping at that station. I think what we're going to see is there will be people using that as an opportunity to transfer between Cathedral Square's metro station and our bus hub, bus and metro hub here, because that line doesn't tie directly into either of those. So rather than get off here and walk over to there, they're going to take this line. Need another new route as well. And that's going to be over in Fitzgerald Square, so that's this way. Got this metro stop here, like City Planner Plays pointed out in his City Tips video. I have this line that's not really tied into anything else. Let's get that fixed. What we're going to do, in order to offer that transfer opportunity, let's see. Alright, what I want to do here is bring this route, start it here, bring it around this way, just giving it opportunities to pick up passengers in places that mean it can meet up with other with this line and then with this station here, and bring that in around back here and tie it back in. It'll just be a simple little circulator line going back and forth, but it'll give us give our riders the opportunity to get onto the subway or subway to the bus line, and also to transfer onto this bus line here. And also while I'm in here, I'm gonna come in with Node Controller and make some crosswalks so that will facilitate some of that movement a little bit better. Not going to do it on the main street here, but I'll definitely put them in place where we're warranted on the side streets. It's a good opportunity here as well, isn't it? And I'm gonna get rid of that node that is now... Oh, it did it itself. Beautiful. Thank you, game. Just more opportunity for pedestrians to get from place to place around where our new bus line is. Before I forget, let's go in and change our bus. I'm gonna use the same one here, that bio bus. And I don't think, let's see, if it's putting it at three. I don't think we're gonna need three vehicles here. I think we'll be able to get away with just two. Though there's quite a lot waiting there already. Maybe I should leave it at three, huh? All right, let's leave it there and let that that take care of itself. We'll have to come back and visit these lines that we're adding and adjusting as time goes on in our build today. Next one I want to look at is over in Prospect Place. It's, yeah, see, look at this. It, somehow these stops got put on the wrong side of the street, I think, is what's going on here. Let's just move that in. Yep, that's all it was. So flip that to the right side of the street there, and it's no problem. I'm going to do the same thing here, though, as long as I'm here. Let's put in some crosswalks. The stops will automatically adjust. Didn't like that very much. That's about all I'm going to do with that right now. Now we're going to work on the one up here in Springerton and Eastley. It's easier to do it this way. Let's find line 21 and 22. That's these paired circulator, mirrored circulator out here. We're missing some opportunities. Why do you have to cross the collector to get to the station in both cases? And then over here as well, like it comes, yeah, it doesn't go anywhere near this other metro station. Those are connection opportunities that we should really be taking advantage of, so let's take advantage of them. Going to come in here to stops, and we'll get this stuff adjusted. Let's bring this down here. Now there's I'll leave those alone. These in. Yeah, I want it right there. It's going to be a little bit more out of the way as far as the trip is concerned, but we'll make this work here in a moment. Fortunately, we were able to put a stop right here under the metro bridge. We're back on the correct side there. I'll deal with the upper end here in a minute. Put another set of stops. Let's have it right here. And we can add a crosswalk here, too. We've already got this bike path coming in here. Let's add a walking path to connect this up as well. I'm going to come in right off of this one that already exists. Everything off. That'll give everybody the opportunity to come from these stops, these new stops right here, and get right down to the station. It's not perfect as far as how close it is, but that's going to make it a lot easier for people in this neighborhood to get here. Even though this is still pretty close, it's not quite as close as this, so it'll serve the neighborhood well. Bring that up a little if we can, make it look better. I think that looks a little bit better than it did, so we'll go with that. Add in some crosswalks where appropriate. I think we're fine there. But here, you can use one. Same thing here, and the bus stops will adjust to themselves, which is really nice. Let's just keep our increasing our crosswalk density. Since we've got a lot of paths going through here, it makes sense for us to give them an opportunity to get through. Back to our stops. These are kind of close now, so let's get these moved a little bit along. Just keep these spread out so they're not crammed in too close together anywhere. We've got a good connection opportunity here. I feel like we're missing here, but I believe I wanted to give better coverage to the line to these folks. Plus, we have another opportunity to transfer between those two lines right here. I'm going to leave that alone, though what I am going to do here is bring this in closer to that. Yeah, we'll leave that where it is, I guess. I can facilitate this with a crosswalk here, too. This feels like we need another set. It's actually a good idea. Let's slide this way. Here, move these up there, and I can get rid of these stops. Slide these down. Add in a pair of stops here. Yeah, a little bit further for that connection, but we've got a really good transfer opportunity there, so I'm not super worried about it. This needs to get moved, though. Way too close to this pair right here. And there's quite a lot down here that's not served, so that'll put a stop in here. There's quite a stretch here, and I know that we've got this stop here as well, but it's fine, I think. Move that. No, I'm gonna leave it alone. Okay, let's get in and make some crosswalks to go with these. Until I've already gone through and done some of this, there's quite a few of them already in place. And I don't need to do that in this entire area, but we've got it good enough. That should increase our ridership a little bit, make it quicker and easier for people to get around. Okay, now our Metro Hub has the next one I want to look at. It's over here between Laguna and Keycrest. At this beautiful transit hub, if for some reason I don't have a stop right next to it, absolutely that is necessary. I'm going to move these up here. I don't think we need these quite so close. Instead, what I'm going to do, bring these up like this. And then I can nix this one here. That'll serve our Channel Street waterfront area on this line and get it down to the Metro Hub just fine. And then this also will go to that transit hub down there. To go along with that, I'm going to modify this blue line right here. Let's add a transfer opportunity to that as well. And then plop another one down. Again, adding some crosswalks where appropriate. That'll help people get around a little easier, which is the name of the game here. I think this stop, moving these stops here, is going to be a huge boon, and they can cross right there. That'll be really easy for them to get access. I also want to do that. Make it easier for people to get to the Metro Hub from the surrounding area. Excellent. That one, that blue one that we messed with, is line 9, and we'll come back and take a look at that as well here shortly. Last thing transit-wise that I want to look at is with our ferries. I know there's not a lot of ridership, and it's an expense that the city doesn't necessarily need, so I'm going to cut back on it, but not remove it entirely. The reason I don't want to remove it entirely is I really like the traffic on the water. I like that there's activity. You're seeing boats buzzing around. To me, it makes it feel real. You'd absolutely expect to see some traffic in this area. In a city like this with such a beautiful wide channel and all this waterfront property and the marina amenities, that sort of thing. there would be use of the waterways. So I want to keep that without it costing the city too much additional money. So let's go to our ferries here. We're just gonna ditch lines 4 and 5 altogether. Those are the ones that are nobody's doing anything on these. So let's just cut these completely. They're not getting used at all. And then we'll rework this network because it's kind of a mess and it doesn't need to be. So I'm gonna pause for that part. We're gonna totally redo all this. We can use our lines, existing lines, to tell us what's going on here. Let's get our snap twos back on. Back to there. But he's using this one anyway, so I'm gonna repurpose that. Not giving me the guidelines out as far as I would like, it looks like. Wait, no, there it is. I found it. And that should let everything kind of sort itself out. It tells me also I don't need all this. Got some extra lines here doing who knows what for whatever reason. Doesn't matter anymore. Nobody's using them, so let's just get rid of it. I don't think this is necessary either. Perfect. So that should clean up our ferries. Give a little bit quicker transit time to the people actually using them. And looks like this isn't even necessary either. But if that's the case, then let's move this out even more. Perfect. That'll let us have our activity going through the water here without spending too much of the city's money on it. Since it's been a little bit now, since we got started on the transit stuff, let's go take a look at the lines that we messed with and see what those are doing. First of all, let's hop into here. I'm just going to look at individual lines first, and then we can look at totals and see what's changed in there. Let's start with line 33. Now we can see it's already getting some good ridership, isn't it? That's this one down here. The new line going into the Karankawa industrial area. Let's see where these stops are at. So that's the ferry stop. We're getting decent ridership, but I don't think we need 5 vehicles on here. Let's cut that back down to 4. But it's good to see that it's getting use. We're getting people out of there. That's the ferry stop. We got people taking advantage of that stop by the metro. Nobody seems to be wanting to go in any further. That doesn't surprise me. I figured that would be more of a get-off-at stop than a get-on-at stop. We got passengers all along the way. Let's see why people are using it since we got some folks here. Yep, he works out here at Bruce Enterprises and is using the bus to get home by public transport. And home is all the way out here, so that tells me that we're doing a good job of giving transfer opportunities so that public transit is a viable option from different parts of the city. Awesome. Next one I want to look at is number 12, here by Cathedral. Whoops. Cathedral Square. That's this one with the shuttles. We got some that are coming close to filling up. 6 might not really be warranted. We could probably get away with 5 here. So let's cut down to 5 and go with that. But again, we're definitely getting more ridership than we were before. This line hardly had anybody on it. And now every, not every stop, but many of the stops have people waiting. A lot of the buses have a good number of people on there as well, even if they are just little shuttle buses. Because before, I don't think anybody was using any of the stops up here at all. But we've made a positive change, and now people who live up here are using, public transit to get home from the high school. Now I'm just confused. This is one of those circumstances where it would be really nice to know what your whole path was. Because I'm not sure why you're getting from, I think it was somewhere up here to a high school all the way out here. And you're using a stop in the Woodland Hill area. I don't know. But it's getting use, and that's what matters. Next line is the new one that we made in Fitzgerald Square. That is number 34. Ooh, quite the popular line, this one. And that doesn't surprise me, considering that it comes from this busy stop, and it's going back and forth through downtown, offering a transfer into this other bus line. Good ridership. I could probably, again, cut back by one vehicle. It should be plenty. I think that's what I was going to do in the first place, but I kind of thought there were a lot at one of the stops, but now that that's cleared out, I think two is more than enough there. And there's line number 7. That was this one here. Just going to see if we were getting extra ridership in here because of the changes that we made. There's some ridership. I don't think it's warranted to have all four vehicles. We could probably get away with two. So let's cut that down to two and call that good. The other two, Springerton and Eastley up here. Once again, this is something that I was trying to be good about before, but clearly I needed to be a little bit better about making sure that our lines weren't over budgeted. That's 21. And we'll do the same thing to 22. This is a much more popular line. I might just cut this back by one bus instead of going any further. Because there's people on all of them, and I don't want anybody, like at this stop in particular, to get passed up. Let's see what happens here. Yeah, if we cut back too much, we're going to miss people on stops like that, so I'll leave that be. This line here too, this 24, we gave a better tie-in transfer opportunities to. Not seeing a ton of utilization. Let's cut this down to 2 as well. At least this is saving us some money, if nothing else. And then the Keycrest lines over here. Keycrest and Laguna. First one is this, line 18. It's the one that we pulled in to be directly next to there. We had a fairly large capacity bus because it is going through downtown. I'm not going to mess with that. If we had an 80-person capacity bus in here, that means it's warranted at some point. I wouldn't have done that otherwise. And you can tell that there's some stops it's picking up a fair amount at. And the other one, then, is the one that we tied into that up here. This one's got the same thing going on, coming through downtown all the way. I'm going to leave that alone. I know for sure that these stations around Stone Circle Park get a lot of action. A lot of transferring comes through here at least it used to. Tell you what, I feel like, well, no, the spacing's pretty good here. Maybe I could move this up a little. Get this one just a touch closer. There's some other stop, maybe a sightseeing tour or something. I don't want to get any further away then. So we'll leave those where they are. Should be fine. In the past, I know that Stone Circle Park was used as a through way for people transferring. Maybe I had a metro stop in here, because I did completely redo the metro network at one point. But it will make it easier for people to cross since I'm here and thinking about it. Fair enough. Yeah, you can tell I've already done some of that here as well. All right, let's move on. I don't need to spend all day in crosswalks. I know that this week hasn't been terribly exciting, but we've really, really got a lot done. The transit numbers, like I promised we would take a look at before, we had 7,781 and 4,696, so not much is different. I'm not terribly surprised. We've got good ridership, just like we had to start with. There's better transfer opportunities in place now to get between lines. So it's a net positive, no matter what the game says numbers-wise. Like I said, I know this wasn't super exciting, but most of the minutia is out of the way now, so we can start getting into the really fun stuff soon. I don't know about you, I loved making this little Crown Point Gardens neighborhood, and I want to get to that kind of stuff again. You've probably noticed that we've left the cleared up area in Old Town undeveloped so far. That's because I have another project in mind for next week that's going to free up even more space in this area and allow us to fill in Old Town with a larger, more coherent development afterwards. In the meantime, thank you so much for watching. Like and subscribe if you feel I've earned it, and enjoy the drive.